I have Nashville and green. The rest are red.
You have two on Christie and two on Nashville, right?
Yes.
I like Nashville more than I like Christie, so maybe both Nashvilles. And...
Did you pull up the picture for this one?
I did.
727?
Yeah, that's the right off Gunston in the alley, right?
Yeah, next to alley.
It's okay. I think I like this newer block
roof,
more.
Newer roof, yeah. That's $5,000, so.
Stevie Hagerman and his dad, Steve, buy up hundreds of Detroit homes every year.
So are we going after both Nashvilles and leaving Christie alone?
Which Christie? The first one?
We got
it's the first of two rounds of the annual online auction of tax foreclosed homes, run by the Wayne County Treasurer's Office.
Now we're going to pass on. Don't bid on that big one.
In a matter of days, the Hagermans will become the new landlords of already occupied homes.
We're closing in on Manning, huh?
You are the winner, 1-4-0-1-9.
I'll wait and see what Stevie says. He knows he's shot.
When this is all said and done, how much money will you have spent?
Under $3 million.
Better.
Yeah.
The tax foreclosure epidemic is a contradiction at the heart of the revival of Detroit, where chic shops and high-rise apartments build up downtown, but east and west neighborhoods are littered with burnouts and board-ups. Stevie Hagerman manages properties on the east side of the city. In the days around the auction, he surveys well-kept, mostly occupied homes coming up for sale.
13870 is my first one. It's going to be right here on the right. Yeah, so this brick one here to the right. It's got a guardian alarm. The roof's in good shape. That's your typical brick three-bed bungalow. It looks occupied. This street, one off 8 Mile, the homes are going to go high. That's one we'd definitely be interested in.
Can you walk me through how you actually make money on this?
The way you make money, you know, say I buy the house you're in personally for $500. I'm now the new owner. I'm offering you a deal to stay there. I'm not charging you a security deposit since you're already there. We'll take care of your major issues, whether, you know, it's roof, plumbing, electrical, tank, furnace. We sign a 12-month lease. You pay me $500 the first of the month. In one day, you know, we've gotten our money back. And then after that, it's profit.
One of the homes he's targeted is Judy Kelly's.
This is a two-bedroom bungalow, but I made it nice and comfy for me and my family.
She's a mental health social worker, making a little over $2,000 a month.
So we can have two bathrooms.
Hot water tank.
She bought her home in 2009, right as the recession hit, for $3,952.
I had to get the pipes changed from lead to PVC.
Almost immediately, her tax bills were crazy high. That's because the value of her home was assessed at more than 10 times the price she paid for it. By 2017, she had racked up $23,000 in back taxes and fees.
What kind of financial strain did that begin to put on you?
A lot, because it seemed like every time they would send me out a letter, I would try to come up with the $500-$600 that you had to put down on it to try to save your home.
As she put a child through college and cared for her dying mother, Judy only managed to pay $1,000 toward the property taxes she owed.
As your home heads into this auction, while you are literally living in it, how are you feeling?
It's a lot of history that I had in this house. All the memories of me and my children, my grandchildren, the holidays. My mother lived here before she became ill. And just to see it all snatched away, it's kind of heartbreaking.
Judy is just one of thousands who've experienced this. Homeowners pay property taxes based on a city's assessment of the value of their homes. Home value goes up, your taxes go up. Home value goes down, your taxes are supposed to go down. When the Great Recession hit in the late 2000s, property values tanked. But Detroit didn't lower taxes far enough. One study found that between 2009 and 2015, the majority of homes in the city were overassessed. In 2010, 85% were. Even with recent improvements, reports show Detroit's assessments were inaccurate as late as this year. According to experts who spoke to Vice News, many of them were so high they violated the state constitution. What the law does allow for is a confusing city-county relationship. Wayne County fronts Detroit any missing tax money, and then becomes the debt collector, charging struggling homeowners as much as 18% on unpaid taxes. If you're delinquent 3 years in a row, state law lets the county take your home and sell it in the auction. So to be clear, if you're like Judy, you got overcharged by the city on taxes. then got asked by the county to pay interest on them. Oh, and then when you couldn't, the county sold your home out from under you. Detroit hit a low point in 2013, when, saddled with $18 to $20 billion in debt, it filed for the largest municipal bankruptcy in the nation's history. Mike Duggan ran for mayor on the idea that he was the turnaround guy, the businessman, the one who could pull Detroit out.
I think starting tomorrow, we're going to start to turn the city around.
The city did improve dramatically, and Detroit just said thank you by electing him to a second term.
Well, thank you, Detroit!
But it happened with a city budget balanced in part on overtaxed citizens. Since 2009, Jerry Paffendorf has studied tax foreclosure and Detroit land ownership.
How many Judys are there in Detroit?
If you throw a stone into the auction properties, you're probably going to hit one. This is a map of Detroit. Everything colored in is a property that's at the tax foreclosure auction right now. So we found countywide 76,000 properties that are 1 to 2 years behind on their property taxes. And we found just about 64,000 that are 2 years or more. And if you go down to Detroit, you can see, I mean, almost everything is tax delinquent. That's pretty indicative of how screwy the situation is.
That screwy situation creates high stakes auctions, pitting people like the Hagermans against advocates like Michelle Oberholzer.
Okay, Keating, Eddie Murray, I'd like to place a bid for him.
Her team at the United Community Housing Coalition uses donations, loans, and whatever money struggling owners have saved to try to rescue houses.
It's not even tough judgment calls a lot of the time because the bidding is so high.
Current bid is at 82. That's our bid, so we're winning.
I'm just going to bid what he's got until you tell me if you want me to go higher.
We're winning?
Yes.
Okay, next.
17366 Apollon, 13,000.
None of these folks have money, huh?
Can I see her file?
Of the nearly 300 auction homes, Michelle tried to buy back. She only won 47.
The bidding has gone very high, so we're not going to be able to keep bidding, okay?
A lot of the messaging from the city and the county recently has made it sound like, well, there are still some foreclosure issues, they're really on the mend. Every year, there will be fewer and fewer people in the scenario you just described.
The volume of foreclosures that we still have is far from acceptable. In another time and place, this would be a moral outrage. And yes, it's lower than it has been in the past, but our standards are completely skewed.
Mayor Duggan and the Wayne County Treasurer, Eric Sabree, have declined repeated requests for interviews with Vice News. In a statement, Duggan's office explained that the city had done significant assessment reductions, pushed for legislation that offered reduced interest rates to struggling homeowners, and made dramatic improvements to the assessment process. But the city has no plans in place to repay homeowners who were overcharged, and the county has no plans to stop selling occupied homes.
What does tax foreclosure do to communities in neighborhoods here in Detroit?
So tax foreclosure has destabilized and reduced the population. It's increased the amount of blight and vacancy in the city, pushing out lower income people, turning owners into renters.
So why would the city and Wayne County have an incentive to keep any of that in place?
There's a big financial incentive to keep this dance going between the city and the county. They always say follow the money, right? If Wayne County and Detroit were not benefiting from the tax foreclosure system the way it is, they would have stopped doing it some time ago.
And now the county may be hooked. Since 2010, the county's general fund has received $456 million in interest and fees from doing this. According to data provided by the Wayne County Executive's Office, without all this extra delinquent tax revenue, the county would be broke. It's good business for the Hagermans.
Yep, just won this one.
Donna takes her time.
They bought 310 homes for just over $2
million. That's 19,333.
Yes, and we won the 20115.
What did we pay for it?
32.
Plus tax?
511.
They won Judy's home for a total of $3,711, a little less than what she got it for in 2009.
Are there any rules here in Detroit when it comes to the housing market?
They would say yes. I mean, you know, you're not interviewing the county, though, so you have to be pretty careful. They would say yes.
Do you think then that you've been able to sort of get in on a market that maybe shouldn't have existed in the first place?
Well, Wayne County sells houses that are occupied. So we are the big bad investor. I bought a home that's occupied. Well, you sold the home that's occupied.
He can have it. I don't know what to say.
Judy is preparing to become a renter somewhere else, She refuses to pay rent for a home she once owned.
I've started packing up to leave this place. I just got a few things to pack, some knickknacks, and just take the old furniture out.
Do you think you'll ever get a chance to own land in Detroit again?
The question should be, would I want to? I'm not sure.